Hello everybody and welcome once again to Forever Stranded. This episode we're going to go and do some travelling, but the very first thing we're going to do, let's do some small travelling. So let's have a look at this. This is something I haven't actually seen. I tried to find lots of information about it, but these quad superframe teleportation frames, if I simply right click this one, I appear here. And if I right click this one here, I come back again. Now, what's difficult about this is how to do it. So let's have a look. What we need is some maps. For that we need a compass and some paper. We need some ender pearls and some sticks. Now the recipe for the super frame is fairly straightforward. Let's have a look at what the recipe for it is. It's just, I think if I remember right from the top of my head, it's just an ender pearl with some sticks around it and you get a super frame like this. I don't think I need any more than one at the moment. And then the next thing you have to do is you have to make a map. So the map is just a compass with four paper around it. No, it's not. It's a map. It's round the outside of it. There we go. So we've got some four maps now. Did I not do enough of those? I didn't. I only did four. That's fine. And then I think I've used up too many ender pearls. I need to get some more ender pearls. Hold on a second. You do like that, and then you get this destination marker. In fact, I think I would just take three for the time being. Might be the wrong number. We'll come back and do that in a second if I need some more. So what you do is, let's say I want to mark this particular place into map now as a destination. So I take where I'm standing. I take this destination marker here and shift right click the floor, and when I do that it goes green. That means its destination is set. So here, for example, if I right click this, I come to below the base and I've got no destination set in it. Here I've got another one. I can shift right click that in, then it goes in. So when I press it again, I come back again. Simple as that. And one word of warning. Here I had a double frame, and I right clicked it with the wrench from AE2, and when I did that it turned it round and turned it into a single one without the marker. I was going, oh, that's a nuisance, never mind, it's got plenty of ender pearls. And you'll see actually there's a load of light blue cable. I haven't made this, as it happens. I discovered this, and where we're going to go today we shall discover where I discovered it, as it were. Why am I going this way? I don't need to do this anymore. Getting through that door has always been a pain. Now I've turned off the journey map. That's for the mini map. That's a reason actually. I can put it back on again so you can see the base. That's the wrong one. Backslash in it like that. But I've turned the other one off so you don't see where we're going to. And I've turned off all the markers. So I'm going to just turn off the marker for home now, before I go there, so you don't see where it is. You have to find it yourself. That's the fun, isn't it? Anyway, I also found loads of other applied energistic stuff, some of which is here. I got a drive. In fact, I got two drives. The terminal I made myself, but on the terminal, it's light blue, isn't it? That's interesting. The dark panels were there and a load of other bits and pieces. So, I shall disappear out there and see you on the way, because there's one place I want to go to on the way, and I'll see you in a minute. Right, I'm back again, and I found this, and I was going along. I said, what's this? It's set one block below. And when I came near it, I found some tracks, so I decided to go and explore it. So let's go and have a look and see what we actually found. If I can get down this, right. And this place is actually dangerous, and should be alright at the moment. I don't expect I'll see too many mobs around. Looking at the minimap, there are plenty around. Let's get my weapon in. Oops, my weapon into hand. They lit up the area fairly well, as you can see. Oh, that's the exit. So the one I haven't visited over. And when you go down this place, it looks like this. There's not much here. Well, except for sort of chiseled blocks and things. And it's some sort of dungeon. And I think it's only one let. And it's not, one of these Doom-like dungeons. You got gravel, and I found some redstone ore and some lapis lazuli ore. Not ore, yep. So we're going towards the mobs. Where are they? I think they're down one of these passageways. I maybe have to get a bit around. Nope. Ah, here you see, there's some lapis lazuli ore here. And they suddenly find a little passageway hidden away a bit. They're a bit hidden, and I've forgotten where it is. There's nothing in here, I don't think, except I did find some empty chests. I think it might be down through here. Nope. It's big enough, I must be able to find it. Let's zoom in the mini map a bit. Oh, there it is, look. There's a load of mobs down here somewhere. And spiders. But I think they're actually around. They sound like they're above. Or maybe below. I'm just wondering where I've not lit up. Here. Actually, let's put on F7 so we can see roughly where we've not been to. And get the torches in hand as well. Skeleton, I want to get out of the way from him, he's nasty. Oops, as I said, let's get number one out and get him there. We are. Let's try that again. So all I've been doing is been doing this all the way through this place. I think I've used up 4 stacks of torches. Don't see too many mobs just around me on the minimap at the moment, so I should be safe enough to light this up. And there's plenty of bats. So you basically carry on doing this. So let's go and look for the next set of mobs. I think they may be down here. I'm just seeing if I can find where I found anything interesting. Ah, there we are. So here was some coal or redstone or iron ore and some chests, and they were empty. I also got here some quartz stairs, actually. Let's just sort him out. It might be worthwhile taking this quartz. Chiseled stuff you can always return back to blocks, and you see empty chests. And not illuminated stairs, that's interesting. Anyway, I don't want to spend too much time doing this. As you can see, there's just plenty of them. Even though I've been down here, I haven't done it all yet. Number one, let's get him because he's an archer, isn't he? A skelly. This place is just monstrously huge. Torches back are going in. Anybody in front of me? Not immediately. Oops, what did I just put down? Oh, my compass, I need that. That's going to take a long time. Come on, I need to pick it up before I tell you what I'll do. Before they come for me. Oops. So, concentration here. Sorry, can't talk so much. There's a skeleton somewhere over there. What's that? A skeleton? Yeah, you can see one. The neat helped in that particular case. Can I reach that? Yes, I can. Good. And there's a creeper. I do like this weapon. So, enough of this. I shall see it in a few seconds when I've done the rest of this. Just clear it out a bit more. There's nothing down here of any interest except for what I've shown you, I think. So let's trundle back towards the exit. Seen torches down where I can see they need to be then. 85 metres. Yes, it's this way, isn't it? And maybe it's worthwhile doing this later on, I don't know. And here's the exit. So, that's it. So, let's get this compass in hand and go back to where this compass is pointing to. It's quite a distance. So, I'll see you in a few minutes. Well, I've arrived. I'm not going to do very much for the time being because it is a blood moon. And as you can see, the compass is now doing its dance. So, we're in the junk. Well, in fact, it's fairly obvious you can see this thing without too much of a do problem. But I'm going to have to wait around until the end of the blood moon because I'm not going to fight all these mobs. There's certainly enough in there to start with. So let's just get stuff out of the way that I don't want. Yeah, let's put the stuff on the index there. Let's get it sent back home. We don't need that. I don't think we need any arrows, but I will double check that because I haven't checked my inventory completely. Let's have a look. Press T. I've got a diamond backpack with storage emphasis, and I've also got applied to this particular diamond backpack this one, the Eternity upgrade. That's the second one. Basically, it means if I die, the backpack stays with you, so everything in here is safe. So I've got food in here, I've got some weapons, I've got some spare armour, and I've got a jetpack somewhere. There we go, it's actually an armoured jetpack. And that's actually not charged up, but I can charge it up. Because also, with me, I've got here this, I've upgraded this capacitor back. It was a basic capacitor back, and now it's a capacitor back, which gives you 4 million RF. And what you have to do, you hold things in your hand, so when I hold this in your hand here, it charges up, and this one should also charge up. So let's have a look. Yeah, so that's now fully charged, and this is fully charged too, so that's quite useful. Well worth taking with you because we're a reasonable distance from home, and this bit takes, well, it depends how skillful you are. I'm not skillful at this, I will be honest. Let's get that back again and put it away. It takes me, don't know how long it took me to do this. Probably about 3-4 Minecraft days. Just to, maybe longer actually, because I ran out of food. Didn't run out of power. As you can see, it's huge, this thing. So, how are we doing? Midnight. I shall be back in a minute when it's morning again. Well, it's coming to morning. As you can see, the sun is rising, the blood moon is going down. What I didn't tell you, it's two bits actually, how I built this platform here. What I was using, I used an angel block and just put it down and then put on top of that some slabs. I've got some more slabs here. So you could basically, and that'll just place it when you're flying and it'll just stay there. And you can place things on top of it, around it, whatever you want to do. Great block, one of my favourites actually. And that was basically, there was something else I wanted to say as well. Right. There are a load of endermen around here. Look at this. Gotta watch some of them because they might actually attack me. Oops, he wants to come up here. But they should start to fall out of the earth, which is what they're doing now, which is great. Okay. So we've got less mobs. I've done this place, or a large chunk of it, but not all of it yet. And I believe there are also plates around here. So let's go and see if we can find the plates. But I can tell you one thing, this place is really, it is huge and difficult. See, there's a spawner. What's that, a creeper spawner? Oops, I'll tell you what, I haven't got a man, this boy. Oops, wrong. Try that one. What? Yeah, thought so. The touch of evil, you just right click it and you should pick it up. I put the torch down, didn't help very much, did it? I think there's more spawners down here too, so let's just put some torches down here. But reach, there we go. If I cover up these areas here, there's less risk of things spawning. Right, here we are. Let's get rid of some of these mobs. Spiders are the worst, of course, because they poison you and they can kill you just by the, almost in one bite. So there's probably two more spawners down here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in from the top. I think that's why I was doing this down here. So I need the different pickaxe. I need this one. Let's just do this one. I think this is the one that's got two. Yes, good. It's got the height one on it. What I should do is put the mini-map on, actually, shouldn't I? If I think about it. So I can see where they all are. There's a whole load of mobs just here. Okay. There we go, now you can see. I've broken through. So we just have to find those spawners. Can't reach there. There's a compressed zombie there somewhere. Just quieting him down a bit. Bit noisy. In fact, let's do this. I shall want that there, that there, that there, like that. Oops, that was a bit of luck, wasn't it? Really, I should block them off, shouldn't I, so they don't come out of here. I know what I've got. In my backpack here, I've got some sand. Let's get it out. Actually, I've got compressed sand. Let's just decompress this sand. I see you. Missed you. And again. So what I was going to do is put some sand down here, wasn't I? Let's do that. Oops, there's a torch in there. so smart. Let's do it down here. Spade's getting out of that hole there, is it? Okay. Why's that not dropping? There must be some placeable sand in the way, huh? And out of here too, okay. So noisy. I've really got to break that, get rid of that place from now, so let's just get rid of him. Get rid of this placeable sand, and then I can put some sand down on here like this. Right, there was another hole. Where was the other hole? Actually, that might do. Oh no, here, look. Yeah, I can see you. So he's come out of somewhere. Where did he get out of? What did you say? Ah, there we are. Can you hear a spider? And they're coming out of there. Let's block that off. Is that just normal spider, or is that a cave spider? I think that's just a normal spider, isn't it? Well, they're still coming out of somewhere here. How are they getting out? They're probably getting out from it. Let's just put some blocks on top of that. What have we got that I can put on top of that? Got some dirt, that'll do. Are they coming out somewhere else as well? Here? So it's a process. Yes, look, here's another one. Let's just put some dirt down on here. Sort him out, and we'll have to get out there now. Because what I don't want to happen is I don't want to be attacked from the top when I'm doing this this particular thing, do I? So let's just wait for him to settle down a bit. Where did he go to? I didn't get him. Well, that's where I want to go down, isn't it? They're probably coming in from out here anyway. I can see you. Right, okay, let's carry on with my hacking away at this thing. Hopefully I've got enough spaces. There you see, there are the spawners over there. So they are about, oops, that was close, wasn't it? Would have jumped on top of me if I wasn't careful. So I reckon the spawners were about here. Let's go and dig those up. In fact, I shall do this, and I don't think I'm going to record this for you, because it's just doing this and carrying on. Hopefully if I get to anything interesting I will do it. But you can see on the minimap there are loads of mobs just right below me. So I'll see you in a short while. Right, got those three, I think. Oops, some more there. What I didn't want to happen. Get out of the way quick. But I think, better eat. Alright, should be alright. I 3 spawners in a row. Nice, huh? It's been like that the whole way through this, so it's taken me ages to do this thing. Let's get rid of those blasted spiders. Are they there? Look. Yes, that was quite brave of me, I realise that. Put a torch down so there'll be no more spawners there. So where are those zombies? So let's have a look. Underneath here somewhere. Okay, let's go and dig my way down here. See you in a few minutes. Well, it looks like I found them. There's a load of spiders as well by the sounds of it. Let's just get rid of these guys to start with. Let's make it a bit quieter. Right, I've already had one night, by the way. I've slept through that. Right, I'll carry on. See you in a few minutes. Well, it sounds a bit quiet now. From what I can see, there is a mob just over here. That's a zombie. Oh, I can see him. Look, there we are. Oops, wrong button. I'll just press 1. There he is. Let's get rid of him. Probably best landing, isn't it? I can dig up sand with a boomerang fairly straightforwardly. Let's put a torch down here. Come on, I want you. Oh, look, here you are. 2 hits for that one. So, I think this is getting a little bit cleared out now. But I believe there are also plates in it. You see, I don't see any more mobs down here at the moment. Let's go down a little bit further. Oh, there's one, I'm for certain. Oh, not yet, Skelly. Not Skelly Creeper. There are a few creepers around here. Look. Oh, see, maybe it's not. There's one over here. Yes, there are a load of skulls in here. And there are some mobs somewhere about. Maybe they're below. Because I can hear some more spiders. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to make this hole a little bit bigger. But that's what I was looking for. Okay, good. Now I have got my wrench with me. So let me just get my wrench out here. And move out of the way a bit. I'm going to just take it on the safe side. That piece of meat coming up here. Well, that was another night. I slept through that one. Let's just go down here and see if I can get that. Where was it now? All these sides, there we are. Ah, a bit difficult. I've got a shiv right click on there. Does that go anywhere? Sky stone. Not really, does it? So, well, there are supposed to be some presses down here, so let's see if we can find these presses. Shall I remove these skulls while I'm here? I don't need any skulls. I've got plenty. Probably less skeletons than anything else. So I'll do a bit of clearing up. I have actually been recording the sort of mining as I've been going along. But judging by that noise, there are more spiders around. So let's go and see, where are they? Over here. So that probably means we've got to go down a bit. This pickaxe, I can go down 2 at a time. So I'll go down. I'll see you in a short while. Well, I've been digging and digging and digging. My pickaxe is just about worn out. I'm going to have to go back to the base to repair. I didn't bring a tool station with me, I should have done. And as you can see, cleared out loads of area. I've still got mobs to keep grind, of course. It's getting towards night time, I think. Yes. And I've also had a look at some of these little ones over here. I haven't found anything in these yet, just dug them out. hoping to see if maybe I could find something interesting. All I found was a few, I found a spawner or two. Surprise, surprise. So I'm going back home and I'll see you when I'm there. Well, just arriving back at home, so to speak. And let's have a quick look at what we have actually achieved. What have I got in my... I think I put everything using the... Oh, let's go the quick way. I haven't done all of this. Ah, one thing I didn't show you about these. I should do that as well. Let's do that. Let's get an empty hand. This one. I'm not sure if I need a name tag. Let's just see if we do need a name tag. I should have name tags in here. One. Brilliant. Okay. So we shall call this... what should we call it? Cellar. I think I can name it like this. Have I got enough XP? You're bound to have 21. Nope. I've got to get the other way around, haven't I? Destination marker. Hold on. I thought you could label these in the anvil. Oh, you can look. You don't need a tower. Enchantment costs one. Cellar. And to get it, put it back, to take it off, it was just shift right click with an empty hand. And to put it back again, it's just shift right click with an empty hand. Oh, no, with it in your hand. So now it says destination cellar. And I can do the same for this one, and I'm going to call this one factory. Oops, come down. Since it's so cheap, might as well just do it, huh? Oh, nice bit of lag. Actually, we did the right click that one. So, Cellar and Factory, as you can see on the top there, it's under the Oala or Walia. It says where the destination is. That's nice, isn't it? So, my chorus plant is still there. Amazing. I didn't expect to see that, actually. The last time I did this, it just disappeared, and over time, it just popped. So, I hope you've enjoyed this episode. Next time, we're going to go and see the tech factory, or the tech, well, one of them anyway, another city I've found. So until then, bye for now.